Hello, it's David here with just some thoughts for this week. Now, in the last sort of 4 or 5 days, we've sort of emerged a bit from the second lockdown, where what's called tier two restrictions. But that gives us a bit more freedom. And, you know, one of the things I've noticed about it is that, first of all, you'll notice I've got a haircut, but also you notice that, yeah, you appreciate little things, don't you? As you come out of, you know, I went for, after having my hair cut, I went for, had a sort of cup of coffee and sort of cake out, sat in a little cafe. And yeah, it was just nice. Something that, you know, I wouldn't have thought about a year ago, really. And just read a book for sort of half an hour. And it seems to me that's one of the things we've started to notice, isn't it? That in this time when we're not being able to do sort of things we've taken for granted, there's been other little pleasures, perhaps particularly that pleasure that's been denied for a little bit, that, you know, we've really quite enjoyed and looked forward to and appreciated perhaps more than we would normally do. And that's all good. That's rather lovely. And I want to think really today about that difference between, or the difference in terms of contrast, I suppose, is what I'm trying to say. Because I think that sort of fits in with Christmas, doesn't it? You know, the light shines in the darkness. Now, I'm a great fan of good lighting, particularly as, you know, I like to do things like reading and working and things. As far as working concerned in the office, I'm very conscious of the light around me. You know, is it easy to read it? Is it easy to see what I'm doing? I don't really like being in gloomy places. And of course, light is very much in contrast to darkness around it. You know, quite a weak light will look quite bright in a very dark setting, whereas perhaps somewhere brighter, you'd hardly be able to see it. And so when Jesus comes into the world at Christmas, we talk about light in the darkness. And so this Christmas, you know, because of COVID restrictions, because we're not going to be able to do everything that we normally do, because it's going to be, you know, a bit perhaps simpler than usual, perhaps we will start to appreciate some of those, you know, simpler pleasures. And actually, dare I say, perhaps with, you know, without the sort of humongous gatherings and people under great pressure to cook for 30 at Christmas, perhaps for some people, actually, it will be a time to sort of step back and appreciate a bit of light this Christmas. And it goes alongside, really, another thing I've noticed, and that is the sort of the secularisation of Christmas. Now, I don't... You've got to hear me out on this, because it's probably not what you... I'm not really having a moan, really. It's just, I basically thought there was the Christmas story, which is a Christian story, to which one of, you know, the world had added sorts of all sorts of other stuff, like Christmas tree and reindeer and snow and robins, etc., etc. And I thought, that's fine. You know, actually, you know, it's not as though everything we do in church is purely, you know, just focused on, you know, what the Bible tells about Christmas. You know, we have a tree and we do have lots of other lovely things, and that's great. I think what I hadn't quite sort of noticed was that, you know, and I guess particularly when you, it's really sort of perhaps looking at more television than usual, really, when you look at the adverts, there's a whole lot of sort of symbolism of Christmas, but of course, because they don't want to sort of, you know, offend anybody, then actually, the you know, there is nothing that is identified by Christian in it at all. You know, advertising at Christmas must be purely about sort of reindeer and family meals and trees and lights and glitter and all that sort of stuff. There must be nothing which has anything to do with actually the Christmas story. Now, I say, in a sense, I'm not really moaning about that, because I kind of enjoy it, and why people shouldn't have you know, a winter festival, why not? I mean, that's a perfectly reasonable thing to want to do. I think my question about that is that I wonder if it doesn't end up being a bit sort of empty. it's a bit like sort of pulling yourself up by your own bootstraps. I mean, because all those things you can kind of do anyway, can't you? I mean, you can have a big celebration, you know, you can have people around, you can, you know, have a bit of fizz and party, whatever. You don't kind of need an excuse to do that. You can do it in the middle of winter, you can have lots of lights because it's dark. But I just wonder whether actually for Christians that theme of darkness night comes a bit more relevant, really, because actually, you know, we have perhaps thought a bit more about the darkness, I suppose. You know, we do know that we live in a flawed world. We do know that we're flawed ourselves. We do know, and it's been brought home with sort of COVID this year, that there are things which make people sad, which make life difficult. There is darkness to be overcome. And, you know, if it sometimes appears, you know, I've talked about this before, about, you know, you don't want to be a sort of killjoy in Advent. But on the other hand, yeah, Advent for Christians is something about making that contrast, about having a bit of sort of fasting and penitence before the big celebration. And I don't think that is entirely about being a killjoy, actually. I think it is actually to sort of prepare, so that by acknowledging the darkness, by being prepared to think about it and talk about it, and by knowing about it, the light appears that much brighter. And that was what it appears to me sometimes with a kind of secular Christmas, is, as I say, which I don't really mind. It just seems shining a torch around. And the danger, I think, is it's shining a torch around really in a world which is daylight anyway. You know, everything's really rather lovely, and I'm going to shine around a torch to just say how lovely it is. Now, for some people, that may be the experience of life, but I'm not sure that kind of gets to really what Christmas is about, which is about light shining in darkness, and the darkness not overcoming it. And I think, you know, when we hear those words in John's Gospel this year, when we've had a very difficult year, when we've got uncertainty in the new year, when, you know, for some people that darkness has been very, very real in all sorts of ways, perhaps, yeah, it will mean something a little bit more. And perhaps because those simpler, quieter, smaller celebrations will just perhaps, in a sense, be more effective, will hit home a little bit harder. You know, actually will be more of pinpricks of light because of the situations in which we find ourselves. So I hope that in this rather unusual Christmas build-up this year, 2020, that we will appreciate the simpler things, the quieter things, the easier things, and also realise how much light there is, how much light Jesus gives us. And sometimes that is by acknowledging that the world is slightly dark, but therefore the light that God gives us is perhaps even brighter than we realised. Thank you.